Mai Shiranui, if I'm pronouncing it right, I never heard her name pronounced before, is hot. Okay, she's a chick from the King of Fighters. She's like the Chun-Li, basically, of that series or fighting franchise. And yes, I believe she's hotter than Chun-Li. She's more sexy than Chun-Li. So if you disagree with me, bite me. She's very fucking sexy. Very hot. A fantastic fighter to use. I love to use her. She has great moves. I mean, she's beautiful. What can I say? I could praise her all day. But so you can imagine my surprise when I found out that she was a DLC character in Dead or Alive 5. You know, I was very excited. To find out that she was a DLC character in the game. Look at that. And I remember looking at, I remember going into the store trying to find her. Because I was playing the game when I found out that she was in there, because you could see her in the character selection screen. And I was like, oh shit, let me go on and buy her. You know what I'm saying? You could still fucking see her. So I went into the store and I couldn't find her. And I was like, where the fuck is she at? You know what I'm saying? I went into the store from the game itself, and I went to the store from the console, and I couldn't find her at all. And come to find out that she was timed DLC. She was discontinued around, I think it was 2019. And I didn't get access to the internet via PS4 until about, what, 2 years later? Something like that. Ooh, excuse me, hold on. Ooh, fucking sneeze. Mucus. Anyways, I was very disappointed and upset about that. I was like, what the fuck is it? What? That's the first time I heard about time DLCs, man. That was the first time I ever heard about it. I was like, what the fuck they talking about? It was only a limited of time DLC. What the fuck? I just couldn't believe that. You know? I could not fucking believe it. But had you purchased her before the date that they took it off, her DLC off, it's yours forever, basically, you know? You don't get to lose the character and all that shit. Now, the funny part is, in Dead or Alive 6, I was shocked as fuck that she was available for purchase in that game. Shocked as hell, you know? And yes, I bought her. So my thing was this. I started asking myself, I said, right, I started questioning, I said, now, since she's DLC in part 6, okay, fair enough. Why hasn't she been re-released in part 5? Why isn't she available to purchase in part 5 then? It can't be a licensing issue because she's still available to this day. And she's not timed. I checked the fine print and everything. She's there forever to be purchased, you know, so you can use her as a character in Dead or Alive 6. But 5, you can't. You can't purchase her. Even though you can see her in a character selection screen. It's crazy. They should have put a patch where she was no longer even seen in the character selection screen. Given if you haven't bought the character or you're too late to fucking buy her in Dead or Alive 5. Crazy, man. I don't understand. I really don't understand that shit. That blew me like a motherfucker. You got this Reddit post a year ago. Is there any way mod cheats, or et cetera. And these companies wonder why people mod their games. It's via PC. Is there any way to unlock Mai in Dead or Alive 5 PC? See? Pretty sure no. The only way is to buy her. Can't do it now. Yes, it is impossible to legally unlock Mai in Dead or Alive 5 last round from now on. See? I'm trying to go to the more details when she, I think she was discontinued in 2019. Can you still get Mai in Dead or Alive 5? The sale of this content will be discontinued after September 11th, 2019. Why September 11th? Ooh, let me stop. You will still be able to continue to use the content you have already purchased. Download this to use Mai in Dead or Alive 5 last round. That's crazy. That's fucked up that she's still seen in the character selection screen. If you haven't bought her, you're too late or whatever, you can still see her in the character selection screen. Man, I just thought that was so bad. I just thought I'd just do a mini video talking about this. I just thought I'd cover this because me and a viewer of mine last night was talking about this briefly. And I just thought I'd talk about it. Look at this. Petition to add Mai Shiranui back into Dead or Alive 5 last round. This was back in October 2021. This has got to be the worst choice that Team Ninja has ever ruined within Dead or Alive, having to remove Mai Shiranui from Dead or Alive 5 last round. Yeah, it's a bad decision. It's a bad decision to remove her for sure. That's crazy. This should have been a petition. I would have definitely signed it. Like I said, she's available in Dead or Alive 6. That's what they probably would say. Well, you can play her in 6. No! You want to play her in 5 as well. What the fuck are you talking about? Crazy. This article is from Lorenzo Butti. Dude, is that your real last name, Booty? I doubt it. I highly fucking doubt it. It's not spelt like Booty. It's B-U-T-I, as you can see here. Lorenzo Booty. Or is it pronounced Butty? Oh my God. Anyways. This has got to be the worst choice that Team Ninja has ever ruined within Dead or Alive, having to remove Mai Shiranui from Dead or Alive 5 last round is absolutely ridiculous. She would have been kept within the game, much like the virtual fighters who were already in the character roster. Sure, I know Mai Shiranui is now in Dead or Alive 5 alongside with Kula Diamond. Dead or Alive 6. I'm sorry. Let me read that again. Sure, I know that Mai Shiranui is now in Dead or Alive 6 along with Kula Diamond, but I miss playing her as... I miss playing as her more in Dead or Alive 5 since she was first introduced to many players at that time. Now I want her back in the game for good. So please help sign this petition to Team Ninja and Koei Tecmo to respond. Wow, this was in 2001. Oh, it is a petition to change.org. I think it's taken down. I wasn't in change.org back then. His goal was 200. He only got 137 signatures. Damn, that's sad. He didn't even reach his goal. Hold on, I'll be right back. I gotta blow my nose.
Oh, shit, excuse me. Fucked up, man. Oh, fuck me. These ailments I have, nothing I can do about it. All I can do is just roll with it. Excuse me, excuse that. Yeah, he didn't even reach his goal for 200. So this is a little note here. I could still sign it. I ain't know I could. I didn't know I could sign it. It's simply not right. Let me see. It's simply not right. Wait, this is not, hold on. I never had to complete my signature like this before. Oh, that's Gerber shit. It's my life insurance. Yeah, I'm kind of, is this legitchange.org or this some fucking scam site? I don't know if that's legit. I'm not finna fuck with it. Okay, licenses ran out. It sucks, but that's inevitably what happens. This makes it even worse that Toei Tecmo will never eventually release the complete version of Dead or Alive 5 with all the DLC. That would easily have solved the problem, not to mention would have made them a lot more money and increased the game's longevity. People prefer Dead or Alive 5 over 6 regardless. They still prefer it over 6. You know, I can see why. Even though I personally do enjoy playing Dead or Alive 6. But I can see why 5 is more better. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. He says, I can still buy a used version of Soul Calibur 4 and be able to play as Star Wars character, but I can't play a Dead or Alive 5 for the first time today and play as Mai. So weird. Yeah, because it's over. The DLC is over. Okay, this person said, you can make a petition, but it's not going to happen, unfortunately. The game's license to have her as DLC is done for plus done for. Plus, she's been out since 2016. That's been 5 years, which is more than enough time to have bought her. Listen to this shit. If you know someone who can, though, maybe you can just have them game share the content with you. You can't do that. Can you game share content with other people? You can't do it on PS4. I don't think so. So it's been out 5 years. So I don't give a fuck if it's been 10 years. That's irrelevant. She shouldn't have been timed in the first place. Not, the other DLC characters aren't timed. You got Kula Diamond. You got, like I said, she's in Dead or Alive 6. She's not timed in that. So why not bring her back in Dead or Alive 5? That's stupid. That makes zero sense. There's no defending this practice at all. No defending it. He says, I'm not saying I would want her back as DLC. I'm saying she would have returned, but only as she's within the game's character roster. Likewise, the virtual fighters, which meant she's free. He says that is impossible. Either the virtual fighters had a different agreement that keeps them in the game no matter what, since they're in the base roster by default. No, you have to pay for them too. Oh, no, you don't. On PS3, you do. / Xbox 360, you have to pay for them. If you didn't buy the, what do you call it? The, from my understanding, if you didn't buy the deluxe edition. He said, my isn't because she was a guest a year after the game debuted. That makes no fucking difference. It makes no difference. She should be available just like she's in Dead or Alive 6. So obviously she's available in Dead or Alive 6 because they got the license for her to be in Dead or Alive 6. Even to this day, she's available. She's not timed. She's not going anywhere. Like I said, you even have Kula Diamond. Kula Diamond comes from the same franchise as Mai does. They added her in Dead or Alive 6. So what are y'all talking? What are you talking about? Why isn't she in 5? Why isn't she brought back in 5? I don't get it. And then he goes on to say, and there is not much they can do at this point since the game isn't receiving any support anymore. What? Plus, she's in 6 anyway. Okay, so that's my point. Why is she in back in 5? There's really no point making a change when they could do something instead for DOA 6. This motherfucker's a fanboy. Okay, Lorenzo says, the person who started this, Dead or Alive 6 was originally the weakest fighting game in the entry back when Dead or Alive 5 did so much better with their updates and improvements. And still to this day, Dead or Alive 5 last round includes a higher number of rosters, like unlike the previous games or that DLC, Dead or Alive 6, which only had about 31 fighters. There's absolutely nothing they ever tried with Dead or Alive 6, and it had a backlash on the recycled DLC. And plus, it was a dick move to remove Mai from Dead or Alive last round. I mean, if it's not broken, don't remove it. Fuck a light. He talked, like I said, this person defended him, talking about a licensing issue. Like I said, she's in 6. If she's in 6, why not bring her back in 5? They ain't doing nothing with 6. We're adding more DLC that's overpriced and fucking exclusive fucking season pass. Oh, you can't buy. You can see this DLC, but you can't buy it unless you buy the season pass that comes with it. And I'm going to tell you what I hate, what they did for Dead or Alive 6. I fucking hate this. Let me see if I can explain it. I hate the fact that they
introduced coins, if you will, for lack of a better word, they introduced these coins that you have to buy with real money. You can't just find a DLC in game and just buy it with your money like that. You have to buy these tickets. No, they're tickets. That's what they are. I ain't played six in a while. They're tickets that you have to buy first in order to buy the skin or the costume, whatever, the look of the character, cosmetics, right? You have to buy the ticket first, then you purchase the item in-game using your tickets that you bought already with your real money. I thought that was stupid. I thought that was a dumb change. That's my main gripe with six was that shit. I was like, why should I buy a ticket? Why should I buy a fucking ticket when I could just get it using my real money? That's crazy. So, okay, here's the defender. Here he comes. He says, no matter what, though, six is the most recent entry, okay? They're not going to up and put Mai in again when she's been up for 5 years to download. Give me a minute. This guy, he's missing a point. He goes on to say, and again, they did remove. That's the misinformation you're spreading. She's still in the game, but because her license expired, she's not available for purchase. Yes, why isn't she re-released since she's in Dead or Alive 6? They're not doing any favors to us by releasing her as paid DLC, mind you, in Dead or Alive 6. Saying, okay, here you go. You got your Mai now. You happy? No, we want her in 5 too. Bring her back in 5. It makes no sense. There is game share though, but again, she's been up for a long time. It's too late. There he goes again. He has no argument. It's not a license. It's a licensing issue. They didn't remove her. She was removed because of licensing, but at the same time, she's available in 6. And plus, it's been like 5 years. She's been up, so. It's like, you don't know why this person didn't purchase her 5 years ago or whatever when she was there. You don't know why he didn't. You know what I'm saying? You don't know what situation. Even going to the situation, I know why I didn't, because I didn't have the fucking access to do it at the time. You know what I'm saying? Not to mention, I had the game on PS3. So I probably wasn't going to even buy it for PS4 if I had internet then. You know what I'm saying? I was playing on PS3. It's like shit, because when I got internet, when I had PS4, I didn't have internet on my PS3 at the time. Yet. I didn't know if I wanted to get internet on my PS3. I mean, I have an account on my PS3 at the time. I didn't know if I wanted to get one. So I ended up buying Dead or Alive Last Round on the PS4. Plus you had that chick, what's her name? The blind girl with the pigtails. I had her as extra kid. I didn't have her on PS3. So I had extra shit going on with the last run for PS4. So I bought that instead. I said, okay, I'm happy now. Because by the time I bought it, in fact, when I bought Dead or Alive last round for the PS on PS4, in fact, last round was only on PS4, not on PS3. It was Dead or Alive Ultimate on PS3. Last round ever came on. There was no last round copy. I mean, you could update it to last round if you had internet on PS3. But yeah, like I said, I bought last round because of the extra shit that I didn't have in Ultimate, you know? So I didn't, like I said, when I bought last round for PS4, I still didn't have internet yet. So I didn't know about no Mai Shiranui DLC at all until after I got internet. Okay, here's his response to the other guy. He says, You don't ever see a license from the virtual fighters getting expired in Dead or Alive 5. It's still a pointless removal that the developers could never have done on my, should never have done. I think English is the second language. Well, he just can't type. Anyways, let me move on. You see how Soul Calibur Games still kept some of their guest fighters throughout their library? That's also because Dead or Alive 4 started the guest fighter approach, and that was Spartan 458, who was like a Halo character. They never removed her. I didn't know that was a she, to be honest. Wow, that's news to me. I do remember Spartan from Dead or Alive 4. Yes, I do remember that character in 360. That's also when Dead or Alive 5 managed to get down on several guest fighters. Likewise, Neotora. I like her. Neotora Lee is fucking dope. Neotora Lee still intact within the game since she was in Samurai Warriors, owned by Koei Tecmo. She was never removed. Yeah, because Koei Tecmo owns her. Koei Tecmo is behind Dead or Alive. Of course, she's never going to be removed. My biggest concern these days would be now that only one iconic fighter was excluded and that Mai Shiranui would have had that playability still be kept within the game, can have that as a game, that as a more remarkable choice. It's hard to read this guy's text, but I'm seeing where he's coming from, that she shouldn't have been removed in the first place. She shouldn't have been timed. I get it. I agree with him. Okay, it's not that it's a pointless removal. In the current case, it's basically asking Team Ninja to pay royalties to put her back up in the previous game that isn't getting a profit like that anymore to cover that cost. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? What? What you mean pay royalties? What? Well, since when is payment an issue? Aren't they making bank with these overpriced DLCs? I guess not. I guess that proves it right there. People ain't buying all this money for all the money that they want for the cosmetics and shit. That's what people was hoping when Dead or Alive 6 came out. They was hoping that Team Ninja was going to at least be smart enough to make the shit cheaper, but no. In fact, It was the same price or more expensive in part 6. No wonder the game crashed. No wonder people didn't want to buy it. No wonder people don't talk about it. That was like the main gripe with part 5 was the overpriced DLC. The packages and shit like that. And then the DLC that you can't get unless you buy the fucking expensive season pass. That was the issue with Dead or Alive 5, basically. They did the same thing with 6. They didn't learn their lesson. And it's no wonder 6 failed. That alone killed it. So he goes on to say, this guy, the cheerleader, he says, so say if you bought her back in Dead or Alive 5 last round, you bought her and you are like, thanks, Team Ninja. But Team Ninja will be like, yeah, but only 45 people bought her. That's not going to cover for how much we paid to put her back in the store just for you. We lost money just for you. What? They didn't lose shit. Team Ninja ain't gonna lose no fucking money, man. Honestly, we're pretty lucky because those characters were expensive. So having them on the base default game is literally the best alternative to having 3 to 4 virtual fighters. Imagine if they were DLCs. The cost of having them return would be a nightmare deal. That's why that's way more expensive than mine. What are you talking about? For example, the character Rachel. You have to buy her again when you bought Dead or Alive 6. And she's not the only one that you have to buy again. People were complaining about that, which is rightly so. They're like, I paid for this character in Dead or Alive 5, yet come Dead or Alive 6, I have to buy the character again? What type of shit is that? Right. Even if that character was free, if you bought last round, Dead or Alive 5 last round, if that character was free, right? Then you bought Dead or Alive 6, all of a sudden you have to pay for that character to be in Dead or Alive 6. That's stupid. So what is this person talking about? It's going to cost them money. What are you talking about? Mai Shiranui is in Dead or Alive 6. Not only is she in Dead or Alive 6, you have to pay for her first. And she's not timed. She's in there. Why can't they just bring her back in 5? I don't understand that. Then he goes on to say, if Dead or Alive had thousands and thousands of players on Smash Brothers level, they probably would be extended that deal or kept it in the game for as long as you like. Granted that it is possible to bring her back in the store. Check Marvel vs. Capcom Alliance 2, where support for the game was done, and that 4 years later, they put the licensed DLC character back up. It's just that there has to be an incentive for a teenager to put it back up in the first place. Incentive. Listen to this guy. Saying, I miss playing her more back in Dead or Alive 5 is just not a good reason for Team Ninja's eyes, because it is business at the end of the day. Unfortunately, what are you talking about? This person cannot access Mai Shiranui. He's not even understanding what the person's saying. How the fuck can you say I miss playing her back in Dead or Alive 5? How can you play? I can't even. What is this person talking about? If you missed the deadline of buying her, you never played her to begin with. So how can you say you missed playing her and you have no access to the character? What is this person talking about? Her activation key is still on PSN. You just don't have the option to purchase her because having it up in the first place is making them pay for the content again. How does that make sense? My thing is, why can we still see her on the roster? Those of us who can't buy her now, why is she still on the roster? What the fuck, man? What don't this person understand? He goes some more. Also, I think it's about that time that we stopped using petition sites. LOL. Laugh out loud. Get the fuck out. Those generally don't work for video game industries. Really? To make a long story short, Sony wanted to take down a PS3 store. That's how I started using change.org was a PS3 store. I signed a petition to keep the store up on the PS3. Yet they changed their minds. I don't know if change.org had a thing to do with it, but Sony ended up not taking down the store. I'm just saying. It's why people voice their concerns on Twitter and Facebook rather than a signed petition, because it's not official petitions. It's just fan-made ones. Oh. Okay.
Okay, okay, here comes Mr. Booty. Basically, I'm the only one still fully supporting Dead or Alive 5 last round since they ended the DLC run back in late 2017. I still refuse to play Dead or Alive 6 after a train wreck of a support that game had to go through. And still to this day, I've seen modders that had to upload custom mods, which they direct it to Dead or Alive 5 last round. The game may be old, but it's definitely worth the playability, and especially how you didn't even need to purchase an in-game costume with microtransactions. That's my issue with 6. Microtransactions. That was Team Ninja's biggest misstep. They're trying to compare their games with Street Fighter V and Tekken. Dead or Alive 5 last round has you unlocking in-game costumes that are completely free. Nothing you can buy with microtransactions. This is just no absolute way people can enjoy the abominable Dead or Alive 6 fighting game without thinking of going back to Dead or Alive 5 last round, because that game's lack of DOA pass content. Oh, because of that game's lack of DOA pass content. It all goes to show that their duplicate recycled DLCs wouldn't be necessary to satisfy fighting gamers. It's like they would never mention that Mai Shiranui was only a timed DLC fighter without ever knowing she would be within the game like the virtual fighters. I'm reading it word for word, so if it makes no sense to you, this is what he's posting down. This has always been deceiving everyone and myself, and still to this day, I will always keep enjoying Dead or Alive 5 last round, even if it means for such a roster the game had to offer us. I'd rather wait for Mai Shiranui to hopefully make a return of playability without having to pay her as DLC, which you did in Dead or Alive 6. You had to pay for her. I would buy her again for Dead or Alive 5 if they brought her back. My issue is, why isn't she in Dead or Alive 5 again since she's available in 6? How is it a licensing issue when they have her in Dead or Alive 6? Why am I repeating myself? I don't know why. Let's move on. Maybe because his mind boggles me and shit as to why this shit is going on. Okay, the defender said, here's a cheerleader, here he goes. Unfortunately, that is the case, yes. Dead or Alive 5 last round actively is mostly a heavy den for modders, which is unofficial support, okay? Both games are no longer being fully officially supported, and I severely doubt Team Ninja will pull up a Marvel Ultimate Alliance to bring back DLC years later for a previous game, especially for a fighting game like Dead or Alive, when the games being played is less than 100 people. It's not enough to cover the cost. What cost? And not worth the risk. The only alternative is to play what you enjoy or move on. There he goes again with the cost. See, it's not about making consumers happy. These companies, all they care about is your money, but at the same time, they don't want to spend extra amount of money so you can purchase and enjoy the game, which is weird. It's like, don't y'all want money? I still think it's okay. This is Booty. I still think it's worth the playability, but hey, there is only so much you can do. If you enjoyed Dead or Alive 5 last round, then absolutely keep playing it. It's not something I would commit to anymore as much as I enjoyed 5 years back. Here's a response to that. He said, hey, more power to you. Ha 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 ha. What's so fucking funny? On the issue with Mai, she's a third party character, so the likelihood of her returning without having to pay is zero chance. I'm not saying bring her back as free. I'm not saying that. Let her be paid. I don't have no problem paying for her. That's not the issue. He goes on to say, her being charged again makes sense compared to Neo Tengu or Phase 4 and possibly Raichu and Momiji, I guess. Asking for free means Team Ninja might as well not include the character at all. You need money to obtain the rights to the character. Yes, Team Ninja would lose then gain at that point. But hey, enjoy what you want to play. Okay. It's not a surprise, though, that they're using their five last round mods. Six is a harder game to mod, and why make new Dead or Alive 6 mods if your last round mods hold up, since that's basically what they do with last round Dead or Alive's DLC to 6. I don't think that's odd, since what other games do when they get new Eric? What did I just read? God damn it. I think I'm done. This is a longer thread than I anticipated. I mean, it's pointless to read anymore. Oh, that was the last one. I might as well read it. Hold on. This is the last thread, right? Again, if Koei Tecmo was smarter, they would have eventually released a complete edition with all the DLC. That's the only way to keep licensed content, in this case, Mai, from an IP that belongs to another publisher without having to worry about it getting removed or for anyone new to the game after the license has run out. That is why we can still play as Virtual Fighter characters, because they're on the discs. They're part of the base game because before DLC. I'm glad I'm one of the people who got Mai in Dead or Five last round, but only for the PS version, which I don't play anymore. Okay. I miss out on her on Xbox, which is where I mainly play now. Not to mention some DLC costumes I really liked. I wish there was something we could do, but there isn't. A petition isn't going to work. Seriously, KT could have waited until they felt the game was old and dying and they were just about ready to start working on a new entry from scratch, then release a complete edition. It's easy money because you would hardly have to add anything more to the game, and it would satisfy anyone who was holding out on buying the game, even with the risk of missing out on the online scene because they didn't want to have to deal with the DLC. And I know there's quite a bit of people like that out there, not to mention all the fans who did buy DLC but would still buy a completed version anyways, like me. There's had to be a point where their DLC wasn't selling anymore. So the smart thing to do is heavily discount old content and make whatever you can off of it. Unfortunately, it seems they wanted to rush Dead or Alive 6 out after Dead or Alive 5 last round was barely even considered old yet. There's only one reason why they wouldn't put out a complete edition, and that's because they were blind by greed. You don't say. Preferring any newcomers to the game or holdouts on the DLC to eventually cave and pay the original price. If they even believe
or care that there could be people who want to still play Dead or Alive 5 last right after Dead or Alive 6 release. I bet you any kind of money that more players are playing Dead or Alive 5 over 6. I bet you it's a strong, I bet you it's about a fucking landslide. More people are playing Dead or Alive 5 over 6. And speaking of which, I haven't even heard of Dead or Alive 6 until I was on Amazon browsing for something unrelated to Dead or Alive. I never heard of the game until I ran across it on Amazon one day. I said, wait a minute, there's a part 6? That shows you how well the game did when it was released. But however, when Dead or Alive 5 was coming out, I ran into ad after ad after ad after ad. They advertised the fuck out of it. Dead or Alive 6 comes out, crickets. Complete science. I mean, complete silence. Church mouse silence. For Dead or Alive 6. It says, then he goes on to say, and there is no way they're going to go back to that. Go back and look at what they can do with Dead or Alive 5, even if that's the smart thing to do, because they don't even put the game or any of the DLC on sale anymore. You don't say. That's how much they're neglecting, ignoring it. When we get Capcom sales or fighting game sales or Japan related or anime game sales, you always see Street Fighter 4 and 5 or a bunch of Blaze Blue or CG or even Dead or Alive 6 part of it, but never Dead or Alive 5 last round or its DLC, at least not on Xbox. Not sure with PS or about PC or PS these days. It was the same with PlayStation. Okay, that's something I want to say before I leave this page here. He says you will never see any, you don't see any sales on the Dead or Alive DLCs. Okay, one day I was browsing on PSN, and to my surprise, not only was the game on sale digitally, which I always saw, I saw that the DLC was actually on sale for Dead or Alive 6. And I saw sales for Dead or Alive 5 for the first time in a long fucking time. I was surprised. I really was that I saw sales for their DLCs. But yeah, when this article was published, there were no sales going on. Cause I was talking about this. How come they never have sales on their DLCs like other fighting games do? You know what I'm saying? They're doing it now. I guess the games are old enough. Cause heaven forbid that they woke up one day and says, man, people aren't buying this DLC. So let's put it on sale and see what happens. I don't think they did that, right? So that's it. That's pretty much it for this screen capture vlog. In closing, it's bullshit that she was even timed. And it makes zero sense that she's available in Dead or Alive 6 as opposed to Dead or Alive 5. She's still unavailable. That's crazy. Why not release her? I don't want to hear about costs, which is ridiculous, because she's available for purchase for Dead or Alive 6. So what are you talking about? So with that being said, this is why Chromosome signed the fuck out. Peace and love. Good health to you all. And be safe out there. Peace. I'm out.